Hello students, today I am going to discuss about the frequency division multiple access and multiple access schemes. So first of all, let us see what do you mean by FDMA. So in this FDMA, we can say that FDMA assigns individual channels, because here the frequency is divided. So FDMA assigns individual channels to individual users. This is very important thing. It assigns individual channels to individual users. Now see this figure. Here we can say that in frequency we have assigned different channels, channel 1 to channel n. Here this is the time division, this is the frequency division, this is the code division. So here the frequency is divided. This is clear from this figure. So from this figure it is clear that each user is allocated a unique frequency band or channel, we can say that. Now we can say that in FDD systems, the users are assigned a channel as a pair of frequencies. One frequency for the forward channel, while the other frequency is for the reverse channel. Now we will see the features of this. What are the features of FDMA? So FDMA channel carries only one phone circuit at a time. If an FDMA channel is not in use, then it sits idle and cannot be used by other users to increase or share capacity, because frequency is totally assigned to a single user. After the assignment of the voice channel, the base station and the mobile transmit simultaneously and continuously. Then we can say that the bandwidth of FDMA channels are relatively narrow, that is 30 kHz approximately, and so FDMA is usually implemented in narrowband systems. The symbol time is large, and so amount of ISI is low, and thus no equalization is required in FDMA narrowband systems. Again, we can say that FDMA mobile system is less complex in comparison with TDMA system, we can say that, or other systems we can say that TDMA or CDMA. Then since FDMA is a continuous transmission scheme, hence fewer bits are needed for overhead purposes. FDMA system have higher cell site system costs. Ninth point is the FDMA mobile unit usage duplexes, which results in an increase in the cost of FDMA subscriber units and base station. And last but not the least, FDMA requires tight RF filtering to minimize adjacent channel interference. So after discussing this, the features of FDMA, now here is one formula is very important to determine the number of channels that can be simultaneously supported in an FDMA system, which is given by n, and the number of channels is equal to BT minus 2 BGAARD upon BC. BT is the total spectrum allocation, BGAARD is the guard band allocated at the edge of the allocated spectrum, and BC is the channel bandwidth. So see one simple example. BT is given 12.5 megahertz, BGAARD is given 10 kHz, and BC is given 30 kHz. Then we have to determine the number of channels. So by simply using a formula, we have determined, which comes as 416. So this is all about this FDMA system.